Guys, Dusty here with finally my retrospective of Persona 3 FES. Yes, Persona 3 FES. We are finally doing the retrospective of Persona 3 FES. So I'm just going to get right into it. I have my notes, so if I'm looking at my notes, I do apologize about that. But, you know, I had to take notes because this game is very deep. So we're just going to get right into it. The story of Persona 3. Well, Persona 3 is the fourth game in the Persona series. Yes, that's confusing. Basically, what happened was Persona 1 came out in Japan, came out in the US 2 years later. At the same time, this game came out in Japan. So they were like, oh, well, we don't want to release two Persona games at the same time, and we don't want to stagger them by 2 years. So what they did was they just skipped that one and released this one in the United States. So in essence, Japan has two Persona 2s, and we have one, which makes the next one, Persona 3, and it confusing in Japan. Which is kind of cool, because they decided to put us Americans over Japan. That never happens. Like, for instance, Final Fantasy. We got 1, 2, 3, and 7. Anyway, so Persona 3 is the fourth game in the Persona series. In essence, you play as a student in a new school, and you find out about this mysterious thing called the Dark Hour. And you also find that you have the ability to summon multiple things called Persona that you can fight with. And you find these shadows everywhere that are your enemies and stuff. Basically, that's the most concise synopsis of Persona 3 that I could come up with without destroying the story, because that's spoiler-free. This is going to be spoiler-free, because I'm going to try to keep the story as hidden as possible so you can experience it for yourself, which I'll get to why that is later in this retrospective. So let's start with the gameplay. Let's get right into the gameplay. Persona 3 is divided into kind of three different styles of gameplay. You got the fighting and RPG part, you've got the dungeon crawler part, and you've got the social you have the fighting RPG dungeons crawler part, you've got the social simulator part, and you've got the fusion and resource gathering part. So now, that dungeon crawler part has you fighting off multiple enemies in a mysterious tower, and the enemies are shadows, as I had mentioned before, and you find an occasional boss floor along the way, which, you know, has just very powerful shadows. And you also have really, really powerful shadows that you fight, occasionally at a certain interval. So, that are outside of the tower, which is kind of a problem because you don't want them terrorizing the town. So, then, of course, you've got the social sim part. The social sim part is fairly simple. You just meet characters at school, at the shrine, at the mall, and even in your own dorm, other fellow Persona users, because there are other Persona users that you're on this journey with. So, basically, you socialize with them and level up things called social links, which we'll talk about in the next kind of section of gameplay, which is the resource gathering and fusion part. Now, basically, you gather resources like medicine from the pharmacy and weapons from the police station, because, sure. And, you fuse your personas, because here's the crazy thing, alright? Your main character is special, because he can have multiple personas, alright? So everybody else is stuck with one persona. You can have multiple personas. It's kind of like Pokemon, basically. I'm gonna use some Pokemon comparisons here. So it's like every other person that you're with has one Pokemon, and you can have multiple different Pokemon, and you can get more and more Pokemon that you can hold at the same time as you level up in the game. So you can actually also fuse that Pokemon, fuse the persona, which is basically like if you took two Pokemon, smashed them together, and took attributes from both. All right. Now, the social links that I was talking about earlier, the social sim. What is the social sim even for? Well, first of all, it's for the story of the social sim, which I'll get to later once again. And also, they actually, when you smash two of your personas together, like Pokemon being smashed together and, you know, they take attributes from each other, they'll level up based off of the number that coincides with that social link, which grows every time you socialize with a certain person pertaining to the link. The link that corresponds with the persona you're trying to fuse. So in essence, this is all really confusing, difficult to explain, and you kind of just have to experience the game to really understand it. And even still, you might not understand it, which I will get to later. Now, let's go ahead and get right into the weaknesses of the game, because there are a lot of them. Now, don't get me wrong, I know I'm going to spoil my thoughts about the game, but I do think Persona 3 is one of the best games ever made. However, it does have some glaring weaknesses. in fact, seven that I have down right here. And the first and foremost one is balance, all right? The game is not very well balanced in certain places, all right? Particularly with floor bosses. When you're going through this mysterious tower, as I said before, you'll fight random bosses, all right, on predetermined floors. Now, those bosses can range from really easy to you're going to need to level. Like, level. That, or you're going to need to try to figure out a persona that can beat that boss, and then you need to fuse that persona. So basically, you're either going to have to grind or smart your way out of grinding. So it's almost... I love that aspect of it, but the grinding is kind of a little bit too much in certain spaces. So, anyway. Next up, you got the second biggest gripe, which is one-hit KOs. You can get one-hit KO'd, and this is a good time to talk about the death system, what happens when you die, because you are going to die 3 or 4 or 35 or 45 times, all right? That's just how it's going to be. You're going to die, and when you die, you go back to the title screen. But don't worry, you can save at the bottom of the tower. But you can teleport to different floor intervals of the tower that you've already made it to. So, in essence, you can save... Then you can go back, and you save on boss floors, by the way, too. So it's not like you have to climb back up to the boss floor every single time. But you do have to go through, first of all, the death cutscene kind of thing. And you also have to go through the loading your save file process, which takes a lot of loading time. In fact, I've estimated at around, it takes probably 4 minutes from death to going back and trying at the boss again. So, yeah, it's a little bit of a penalty of load times. But... enemies can one-hit KO you, all right? Which in essence means that happens a lot. You die a lot, all right? The only thing that can protect you, too, is something called a homo nucleus, which are very, very rare, or having a persona that basically is immune to the skills that can one-hit kill you. So Hama and Mudo, or light and dark skills. So without going too deep into it, that is a huge problem, all right? Because... you know, the rest of your party will be perfectly fine. Yeah, they could revive you. They could absolutely just pull a revive out of your pocket. Wake up! You're fine now. But no. You dead. Alright. Now, the other characters, alright, they don't have this problem. Alright, if they die, you just revive them. Which brings me to my next point, which is the character AI. Alright, the one of the big glaring issues. Now, I like to think of this as glass half full, personally, myself. I know a lot of people harp on the character AI a lot, but I would say that 95% of the time, the character AI is brilliant, all right? It makes the right moves, and it is altogether that characters having an AI, because I should mention, you don't control your other characters directly, all right? You have three other party members, including yourself, and kind of like, you know, Final Fantasy or whatever, and, you know... you don't control them, all right? You assign them tactics to do certain things. So, like, for instance, you'll assign them, you'll make them basically do whatever they want, or you'll make them only attack, or you'll make them only heal. So, basically, you'll assign them healer, offense, buff. Actually, healing and buff, or healing and support, as it's called in Persona, are actually the same attribute. But certain characters can heal, and certain characters can support. So, you know, it kind of works out that way. But, yeah, the character AI works in a very specific way that's really bad. So let's just say you're at 2 HP and another teammate is at 1 HP. Instead of healing you, they will heal the person at 1 HP. They will heal the person with the lowest health. Which, if they die, it's perfectly fine because you can just revive them the next turn. If you die, you're dead. You go back to the title screen. All right? So that is a huge, 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 huge problem. All right? Which they luckily fixed in Persona 4. But, you know, still. Big problem when you're playing Persona 3. Next up is the floors are kind of bland. Alright? They don't really change up design too much. Now, luckily, they are procedurally generated. Which means, in essence, the game uses an algorithm to basically generate a new floor. So, like, let's just say you go to floor 35. It'll be a different floor 35 every time you go to it. So the layout of the floor will be entirely different. But the design will always be the same. And there's only, like, 5 or 6 designs in the game if you include the extra dungeons. So, yeah. Kind of bland. didn't bother me as much, but if you really need variety and spice in your RPGs, that might hurt you a little bit. Then 5 is Fusion Confusion, all right? Fusion is confusing, all right? It takes a lot to wrap your head around it. The game doesn't explain it very well. I would recommend looking it up on YouTube and searching it out if you are planning on playing Persona 3 FES. 6 is the move names. This is just a little gripe that you'll get used to very quickly, but Atlas, typically in their Shin Megami Tensei RPGs, uses certain names for different elements. So instead of using, like, fire, ice, wind, they use Augi, Bufu, and Garu, all right? And instead of light and dark, they use Hama and Mudo. You know, they have different words for everything. So you got to learn all those. There's only like 9 of them, so it's not really a big deal. You can learn them fairly quickly, but it can be confusing at the beginning of the game, trying to figure out what you're supposed to be doing and what moves are, you know, effective. Like when they say, use Augi skills. What the heck's an Augi? You find out that means fire. And then 7 is the load times. Load times are long. Load times are really, really long. And not necessarily the individual load times, because the individual load times are kind of fine. But it's starting up the game, which keep in mind you have to do multiple times because you will die. And there's also, you know, multiple loading times. There's loading times basically every time you do something different, there's a load time in between. Every time you advance a floor, there's a load time. Every time you go from one room to another on, you know, in the hub world, basically, it's a load time, all right? There's a lot of load times, and I would highly recommend playing it on either a hard drive, PS2, or, you know, the PS3, because of those load times. I've heard the load times are much faster on the PS3, by the way. I can't confirm that because I don't own it on the PS3, but I've heard such things as those. And then, that's basically it for weaknesses. That's all that's wrong with the game in my eyes. I can't think of anything else that was actually really bad with the game. Now, let's talk about the strengths of the game, because this is, as I said before, this is one of the best games of all time, in my opinion, all right? Now, the strengths, for one, are, notice how I didn't say anything bad about the social link part of the game. That is because I couldn't think of something bad to say about it. Like, literally, I tried to be as antagonistic as possible. I couldn't think of something. I mean, besides the load times, all right, besides the load times going from place to place, I couldn't think of something bad about the social link part of the game, all right? The characters are relatable and fantastic that you associate in social links. They have great backstories, and they have great stories unfolding before your eyes every time you visit them, which makes you want to advance those social links. And they also have, I'm not going to get into any spoilers here, but they have great payoffs, so I'd recommend maxing out as many social links as possible when you play this game. All right, next up, the menu system in combat is brilliant. All right, now the menu system in, you know, the overworld and stuff like that is okay, but the menu system in combat is brilliant. After like 5 hours, it just becomes muscle memory. It's on par, if not better, than Paper Mario's menu system, which I have always touted as the best menu system of an RPG. Not anymore, all right? Persona 3's is really, really good. I mean, yeah, sometimes it can be hard to find certain information, but the menu system is just incredibly simple and incredibly great, and I love it, all right? And 3, the story is brilliant, which is why I'm not spoiling it. Why I said I'm not going to spoil it, why I promise I won't spoil it, because it is brilliant, all right? Now, some people think it's overly dark, some people think it's cheesy. I think it goes perfectly with what it is trying to do, all right? And it tells an amazing story, and I would highly recommend playing the game for just the story alone, all right? 4, the character development is amazing, all right? The characters basically transform before your eyes, all right? It is amazing, all right? You grow with them. All right, because I should also have probably mentioned this before in this retrospective. However, the game kind of goes off of a calendar year. So you're basically playing the game through 365 days of in-game time. So over that time, the characters develop, they change their personalities, you know, strengthen, and, you know, they become stronger people. And it is amazing to watch that. And it is amazingly wrote, and I commend Atlas for such a feat of writing. All right. And of course the music is just amazing. Seriously, the music, it may not be everybody's thing. It's basically, kind of J-pop acid jazz, but it does it very well and it fits perfectly with the game. In fact, let me put it this way. All right, so when you're just battling regular enemies in the tower part of the game, which is basically going to be 20 hours of your gameplay at least, probably, the same song. It's the exact same song. However, it never gets old. That is how good the music is. When you're exploring the tower, same song. Always the same song. But it never gets old. It is that good of music that it never becomes stale, which is brilliant. All right? The art style is amazing. All right? The character designs are amazing. The sprites are fantastic. All right? Everything about the art is just vibrant and colorful and wonderful and beautiful, and I love it. All right? The overall experience is one that I'm so glad I had, because that is a big issue with the game. Like, for instance, if you take a game where it's like, yeah, I kind of wish I spent my time a little bit differently. And keep in mind, this game took me at least 95 hours to beat, not including, you know, all the times that I died and couldn't save. I'm just using the, save time file. Because the save file tells you how long you've been playing the game, but it doesn't count for, you know, times that you died and didn't get to save. So at least 95 hours into this game, and I am so glad that I spent every single minute playing this game. That is big. All right, that is a huge, important deal. And I was actually sad when the game was over. I really wanted the game to continue longer. But, you know, sometimes with games, you just want to get it over with so you can go to the next experience. This game was not one of those, all right? I really genuinely loved the story. All right, I genuinely love the characters. I genuinely love the gameplay. And honestly, I was so sad to see it end. However, the ending was amazing. All right? The ending was amazing. That's all the words I'm going to use, because once again, no spoilers. And then, of course, we're going to talk about the different platforms, the different ways you can play Persona 3. For one, you got, let's see if we can find it here, the original release, Shin Megami Tensei Persona 3. Don't play this one, because this one not only is basically the same expense, but it's better in every single way. And by the way, I did actually play that one, but that one was my sealed copy. This is my non-sealed copy. This game is so good that I have it sealed and not sealed. This game is so good, I actually bought the regular version just for the art book and soundtrack, and it was like $30, and it was $30 well spent. All right, because the soundtrack is amazing and the art is amazing, so the art book is amazing, basically. But I think this is absolutely worth owning if you're a fan of the game, but don't play Persona 3, play Persona 3 FES, all right? Or play Persona 3 Portable, which we'll kind of get into the differences. So Persona 3 FES is the version of the game that I played, as I mentioned before. It basically explains, it expanded and fixed Persona 3 with additional content, such as new personas and new difficulty mode, which don't do it, don't play hard, don't do that to yourself, okay? Please, okay, seriously, PSA, look into my eyes, look directly into my eyes. Do not play it on hard unless you know what you're doing to yourself. Okay, now that we got that part out of the way, which we'll explain the difficulty a little bit later, but basically, Persona 3 FES is fantastic, and it's $10 on PSN for the PS3, and it's about 15 bucks on eBay at the time making this video. So go buy it. Just seriously, go do it. Go. You're doing yourself a disservice if you don't. Heck, if you don't have a PS2, go buy a PS2, and then buy Persona 3 for it. No, buy the PS2 for Persona 3. That is how much I like this game. All right, now, yeah, I know it may not be for everybody, particularly for the weaknesses, but if you saw the weaknesses and it's like, that's not a big deal, as long as I need a fantastic story, I would recommend it 100%. So, then of course you got Persona 3 Portable. Where is Persona 3 Portable? Persona 3 Portable is right here. Persona 3 Portable is basically a different version of the game. The way I see it, let's grab these games again. Persona 3 Portable expanded from Persona 3, not from Persona 3 FES. So basically, it's missing a lot of the stuff that FES had. Like, particularly, and I forgot to mention this, The Answer, which is basically a 5 to 10 hour extra expansion to the game. Or I suppose they say 30 hours, but I just watched the cutscenes, which were like 5 hours. Because let's talk about that when we get to difficulty. But, yeah, it's a very different version of the game, Persona 3 Portable. And it adds a female protagonist option, along with new social links. You get direct control of your party members, so the AI part is a non-issue. However, there are big caveats to it. For one, there is no cutscenes because the PlayStation Portable couldn't handle them. And also, there is no The Answer, so you don't get the extra 30-hour thing, which we'll talk about later. And it's $20 on PSN. So basically, if you have a PS3, probably would recommend buying Persona 3 FES, rather than if you have a PS Vita, buying Persona 3 Portable. And I forgot to mention, too, Persona 3 FES is PS3 only, no PS Vita, and Persona 3 Portable is PS Vita only, no PS3. So, next up, let's talk about the difficulty, because I'm about to run out of time on my recording. The Answer is hard. Hard mode is hard. And when I say hard, I mean really hard. Unless you are seasoned in Shin Megami Tensei RPGs, don't even touch it. Don't even look at it. Don't even think about it. Just play medium. Don't play easy, because first of all, I would think that it might be a little bit too easy. And also, from what I've heard, and this, I can't confirm it for myself, but from what I've heard, you don't get the good ending of the game, which is a very serious issue. So, yeah, basically play it on medium, okay? And my final thoughts. Let's talk about my final thoughts. My final thoughts is this is a game that I think everybody should at least take a look at and determine if they want to play it. Go watch a Let's Play of it, okay? Watch a Let's Play of, like, maybe a few episodes of the Let's Play. See if it's something that you'd be into. Because if you would be into this kind of thing, you probably already played it, or you probably already heard of it, and I would 100% recommend it. It's not going to be for everybody. For people who like, you know, for people who like platformers, for example, because it's a completely, entirely different game. But if you like RPG, if you like Pokemon, but you want something more in-depth than Pokemon, absolutely go for it. If you like RPGs where they punish you, but there's a big payoff with the story, all right? There's a big payoff with, you know, the character development and everything like that. And if you love games with huge and amazing stories, I think you're doing yourself a great disservice not playing Persona 3. And also, I should mention, for anybody getting into the Persona series, where would I recommend starting, having only played Persona 3? I'd recommend starting with Persona 3. Definitely don't play Persona 4 first, because from what I hear, if you play Persona 4 first, it will ruin Persona 3 with you, for you. Because from what I hear, Persona 4, this game right here, is so good that it makes Persona 3 look bad. If that makes any sense. So, yeah, this is basically an amazing game, but play this one first, all right? Or else, if you play this one first, this one won't be as good. And then from what I hear, we have this, these games are so different that it doesn't really even matter. The Persona 1, Persona 2, and other Persona 2. They're so different to Persona 3 that you could really play them. You could play Persona 3 and then 4, and then you might not be into these ones. From what I hear, Revelations Persona is definitely not for everybody. Persona 2 is a little bit more accessible, and other Persona 2 is also a little bit more accessible. So, yeah. I, for one, am planning on playing them all. But, and then, of course, Persona 5. Persona 5 is coming out. I think from what I have researched on Persona 5, it is a good place to start. Too. So you could either start Persona 3, Persona 5. I'd recommend Persona 3 just because, once again, Persona 5 might be so good that it'll ruin Persona 3 for you. But anyway, moral of the story is start with Persona 3. All right, and play it. Or at least look at it. Look into it. Okay? Because seriously, I feel like you're doing yourself a disservice if you don't. It is that good. It is one of my favorites. I would say comfortably it is in my top 5 favorite games of all time. If you're looking entirely at my top 5 favorite games of all time, it's in there. It is just such a good story, such great characters. You feel like it's an adventure. You really do. So yeah, I think I've rambled on long enough. This has been Dusty. Thank you guys for watching. I am planning on doing more retrospectives eventually. I have this pile of games that I've beaten / just about beaten. When we're talking about Legend of Zelda, Ocarina of Time. I've beaten all these other ones, though. Ace Attorney, this one. And I'm planning on doing retrospective of those. So, if you would like to see those, feel free to subscribe to my channel. Or, if you're subscribed to my channel, just look out for those in the future. And say if you want me to make those, because, you know, I don't know if I'll go to the effort if nobody wants to see them. Because, you know, these... I have to write notes for things like these, and writing notes is hard. I'm not in school anymore. My brain doesn't work that way. But anyway, this has been Dusty. Thank you guys for watching. Have you ever played Persona 3? Have you ever played any Persona games at all? Let me know in the comments. What do you think about Persona 3 if you played it before? And all the new viewers, go ahead and go down there. Just make sure not to spoil anything, because once again, the story is very important. So make sure not to spoil anything in the comments if you're talking about it. But this has been Dusty. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see y'all next time. Take it easy. Thank you.